Well, joining me now to discuss the merits of English wine is the wine expert, Oz Clarke. A pleasure to meet you, Oz. Thank you so much for coming on. How excited are you that this year's going to be a bumper year for English wine?
Oh, I think, look at the weather outside today. 23 degrees in southern England. It's so exciting. There are enormous grape crops of beautiful, bulging grapes just needing a few more days to really ripen. And I look at the long-range weather forecast day by day, and there's a high pressure out there. We're going to have more of this weather. We're going to make fantastic wine.
And talking of sour grapes, why has it been so bad for France?
Oh, you know, maybe it's sort of hundreds of years and it's their turn, because poor old France, you look at the clouds all over the place. Corfu, I believe, was pouring with rain in Greece today. Southern Italy's been raining, southern France. It's just bad luck. It may be global warming. It may be the sign of the future.
Wouldn't that be nice? Maybe. So, OK, we're going to put your money where your mouth is. I'll make you work for your living this afternoon, because we've got in front of us, as you can see, three different red wines. One is English,
yes.
One is French, and one is American. Now, we would like you to try them as we have a little chat as well this evening.
Yeah.
And if you could spot the one that you think is English, you can take it home. Does that sound like a good deal?
What, have you got a second bottle of it? I'd take the half-empty bottle home and everyone says, gosh, look at it.
Why don't you start with the one nearest you?
Yeah.
Have a quick sip of that and tell me what you think of that one.
OK.
Nice full body
red, isn't
it?
Got a really dark colour.
Very dark. This is the best bit when you have a good slurp. What are you getting there, Oz?
It's very spicy.
Is it?
It's very ripe, extremely spicy. If this is English, I would be completely delighted, because it's normally in England, you can make wonderful sparkling wine, you can make very good white wine, but you need more sunshine
for red wines. Which you would assume would be harder to
20 years ago, you could hardly make any red. Now you can make some quite good red, and in 20 years' time, we might be making some of the best reds in Northern Europe.
Hopefully. Right, put that back nice and carefully, if you don't mind. What about the one in the middle? A little lighter, I would suggest.
Lighter, quite fresh looking, but definitely lighter.
How does it smell?
It smells like sort of apple juice rather than wine. It smells very nice, but it smells more like a white wine than a red wine.
And taste? Not a fan.
I quite like it. It's slightly sweet. It's soft and gentle and sort of mild. I am a fan.
Okay.
I'm just wondering how much of a
fan. Right, what about the one nearest me? That looks even lighter, I would suggest. Have a quick sniff and a quick sniff.
That is definitely lighter.
You're making me thirsty. What are you getting there, Oz?
Well, the point is, it is lighter. It's got a lovely flavour. It's almost as though you've got something like cranberries in it. And my immediate response would be that this would be something like a very nice sort of Pinot Noir from somewhere cool, like England. That would be my immediate response.
So, out of the three, which one do you think could be English wine? Go on.
Of course, normally I'd have to go back five or six times.
as much as you like.
I would have said that this one is the most likely to be the English.
Okay, yeah. Which is your favourite, out of interest?
I think this one might be, because it's very refreshing.
Let's have a quick look, shall we? Are you ready? Is Oz Clarke right? Look at that.
It tastes like a Pinot Noir.
The lightest one was the English. And let me tell you where it's from. I've got this here. It's a Gusbourne, Pinot Noir from Kent. It's nearly £20, £19.95. I mean, it's expensive stuff, isn't it?
Yeah, because I think that England have done exactly the right thing. They've said, we're making a high-quality product. We're not going to sell it too cheap.
The one in the middle?
The softer, the gentler, the sweeter one. Yeah.
Just very quickly, there was a California one, a Zinfandel.
Yeah.
There you go. And the dark, really rich one was the French one.
Oh,
there you go.
It was very, very nice, whatever it was.
It's a Madeira classic from Languedoc.
Now, very nice.
Quick question, actually, for you. James Barrett sent a message via Facebook saying, maybe now more people will try English wine and realise the prejudice against them was unfounded. Because there has been a bit of snobbery against English wine, hasn't there?
But less and less. And I think it's a wonderful new generation of 20-year-olds and 30-year-olds coming through who are prepared to, if it's authentic, if it's real, they'll pay for it. They haven't got a problem with traditions. It's just the same with beer. It's just the same with all kinds of stuff.
Will price come down, do you think, if it gets more popular?
Only if we make too much. I mean, I reckon we might make 6 million bottles this year, not 4.5 million bottles. But I don't want the price to come down too much, because you can't make cheap wine in Britain.
Fair enough. Mark Powell again on Facebook says, it's not just English wine, a carried wine from Wales is the best you'll taste. Do you like Welsh wine?
Yes, I do. There's one called Mono Valley from Monmouthshire, which I absolutely love.
Scottish wine?
Oh, there's one in Fife. There is. If Scotland, if you are still British tomorrow, Scotland, open a bottle of Fife white wine.
Oz, thanks for being a great support, and congratulations on choosing the right white wine. There you go.